Listen to the vocal harmony there. Hi, this is Kyle with Music as a Verb, and today I'm going to be listening to NDA by Billie Eilish. As always, as I listen to the song, I'm going to try to pull out a list of qualities, the theory, production, and songwriting techniques that I think her and her brother slash producer Phineas used while they were writing the song. Let's take a listen. All right, some like synth or guitar feedback, swelling, and...
Did you think I'd show up in the machine?
Cool.
Had to save my money for security. Got a stack of work and nothing on the street.
So always we have to start it right away because I start singing the bass line. I'm hearing bop, 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 which is G. So this song is in G minor. Bop, 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 bop. I'm hearing that is la. That's the resting tone. So I know it's in G minor. Bop, 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 bop. And we'll see if it goes anywhere from there. Really, really cool how that groove comes in.
Says he's Satan and he'd like to meet. I bought a secret ass when I was 17.
It's like a four chord. It's real, so low it's almost hard to tell. Back to one. Cool, like a pizza, dum dum da. Arpeggio. Yeah. And the arpeggio moves up to the four chord. Cool. So let me stop it right there. So I feel like I have to talk about how similar this sequence is to Bad Guy, which is Billie Eilish's probably biggest hit, right? She has a arpeggio pattern that starts on the one chord, ba, la, do, mi, and then it moves that sequence up to the four chord, and it doesn't really change anything. She does the same thing in this song. In Bad Guy, it's bo-da, bo-da-da-da-da-da-da, bo-da-da-da-da, and then it moves up to the four chord, ba-da, bo-da-da-da-da-da, bo-da-da-da-da. Well, here, she's doing that same thing, it's just that the pattern's a little simpler. Bum, 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 bum. Bum 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 moves up to dum bum 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 bum. It's a very similar thing, but it's just as effective in this song. And the grooves and everything else are entirely different, right? But that idea of taking a pattern and then sequencing it up through the chords that you're using, same exact thing as Bad Guy and done really effectively here.
You couldn't save me, but you can't let me go.
So we've got one, flat three, up to flat six, to five this time. Woo! Would not be a Billie Eilish song without a five, a major five chord in minor, right? This song is in harmonic minor. And that makes it a Billie Eilish song to me. It's kind of a cliche for her to use them, but it sounds so awesome. And honestly, it'd been a long time since I heard any of them in pop music at all. So, so cool. What she does with the chorus there is cool too. It's not the same pattern twice in a row as my ear was expecting. She actually surprises you by hitting that five chord. There's that note from Bad Guy. That's really cool. She's taking a minor chord here, G minor, la, do, mi, and she's switching out mi with may. And every time she does it, she's kind of making it a one diminished chord. Although I don't want to say certainly that she's switching the chord here, it's kind of just that she's switching that one note, right? It's a guide tone that switches down and changes the quality of the chord. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Very similar and also reminiscent to. That diminished chord is so cool because nobody in their right mind would audiate that during the first verse when you just hear it be G for that whole time. Bum, 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 bum. There's no way anyone is hearing that that's switching from minor to diminished. You're just hearing G minor that whole time in your head. But then she gets to fill in the blanks in the second verse by adding an instrument that goes, hey, by the way, it wasn't just la do mi. Sometimes it was la do me. And that changes how your ear hears that whole thing. In fact, I bet if I listen to the song again and listen to that first verse, now I'm going to be audiating that synth line, ba, 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 and I'm going to be hearing everything differently, even though it wasn't the way I heard it the first time. It's almost like a audio illusion, right? She's filled in information and now I'll hear it differently forever. Yeah, that's cool. Up to the four chord. So on the four chord, it changes. La, re, fa. Perfect outlining of the four chord. And then halfway through, it switches to la, re, mi, which is the ninth of the four chord. So it almost makes it this kind of four minor nine sound when you put all the notes together. Although the arrangement is so sparse, you don't get all of those notes. So it's a little different than that. Yeah. These ad-libs. Listen to her ad-libs. They're switching from the left to the right the whole time. Billie Eilish has this way of treating ad-libs like she's a rapper that you hear so commonly in certain styles of rap music in her music, which is decidedly not rap, but she borrows that technique of like echoing the lines, but she's not using echo, right? When she goes, da-da-da-da-da-da-da, hate it here. It's not an echo going, hate it here.
Hate it here.
It's instead her actually singing the ad-lib going, hate it here, hate it here. You know, and she adds these little things that add so much to the character of that verse of the song. And they add an energy, even though no one would call this part of the song super energetic, but they add so much interest and so much energy and movement that you just don't get bored at all. You just want to keep hearing what she's going to say next. It's a really cool way to utilize call and response in modern music. Fun, getting older now. They didn't change my number, made them shut his mouth. At least I gave him something he can cry about. I thought about my future, but I want it now. Boy, I'm those like string, pizzicato strings. I'm sure it's just a patch on a keyboard, you know, but it's very cool. Bum, 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 bum. Follows the things. Yeah. Very cool. Chorus. Love how this kind of, it's like a drop chorus effect, but then it comes in. So cool how it's displaced too. Every chord in the chorus. Yeah. Da 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 da. All of the chords in the chorus are displaced rhythmically. They all come in like a beat before you would expect them to. It's really cool. I'm gonna play the song again and listen to how every single chord is anticipated. They all come in a full beat before you might expect it to. It gives a really disorienting feel for the chorus, which I think is exactly what she wanted. Let's try it. Here we go. Listen. Happens just a little early. Listen to the vocal harmony there. No, she's singing T over the flat six chord, fa, no, which is actually, I'm just now that I'm singing it out loud, this is the exact same thing that Driver's License did by Olivia Rodrigo. It was my last video on a song. It went la, ti, do, and Billie Eilish is going do, ti, and hanging on it till it goes T becomes the fifth of the five chord. And then she's a vocal harmony on top of that going Re. Also a weird note for that chord, by the way. Re. And staying on it to become Re, the flat seven of the five chord. All right, so I just rambled on about that, but let's take a listen to it again, and really I want you to focus on the vocal harmonies this time. Listen to how her melody winds up on T, and her harmony above it winds up on Re. And those two notes, T, Re, are happening over the flat 6 chord. Really funky sound. But then that bass is gonna drop to me and you're gonna get the same notes. Where they make more sense going back to la, going back to the 1 chord. Let's take a listen. So cool. It ends the song on that 9. And then of course, what a cool way to end the song, and one you do not hear a lot right now in modern pop. And all of that is just a cherry on top of the fact that the bridge is the chorus of the song. It's like the end, it's the highlight. We work our way up to this huge bridge. Dun da la da. Yeah, da da da. Da la da. Da la da. Ooh, and she uses that T note there too. That's really cool. I got carried away there. She uses that as the highlight of the song, and then what happens after it? Will we get another chorus? Are we gonna come back to a chorus now? No. It's the end of the song. That is so cool. This is the exact thing that I was just kind of going nuts about in Driver's License, the Olivia Rodrigo song. Is this like a trend now? Is this just what songs are going to do? Is their bridges are really going to be the chorus payoff, that they make you wait the whole song and then get the payoff at the end?
Boys, open your hearts and listen. We're about to get the bridge of our lives.
I have to admit, if so, that's awesome. It's not what we're used to, and it really plays with my expectations of pop song form, right? If I was listening to something else, if I wasn't listening to songs on the top of the charts, I might be expecting something like this that slowly builds and then gives me a payoff at the end. Not in top 40, though. It's not something I've come to expect over the last 20 years of my life. This is a really cool way to give the listener something to look forward to and then slam them over the head with it, and then song's over. If you want to hear that section again, hightail it back to the beginning and let's start the whole thing over. Awesome. If you have questions about absolutely anything I said in this video, leave me a comment below, or you can reach out to me on Instagram at musicisa_verb. If you liked the techniques that you heard in NDA, you should definitely check out my video on Driver's License by Olivia Rodrigo next. Thanks, and I'll see you soon.